Old school DVD camcorders have become popular lately, probably because they use CCD as a pickup element, which gives the video distinct 90s, early 2000s look. They are abundant and affordable on eBay. You can easily get one for $50 or less, often with the bundled accessories. Most DVD camcorders record standard definition video, although half a dozen models can record in HD. Standard definition DVD camcorders record video in either DVD video format, which is similar to commercial DVD video discs, or in VR format, which is not compatible with standard set-top DVD players. VR mode allows editing movies directly on your camcorder. Movie clips can be deleted anytime, and the space they used becomes immediately available for further use. In video mode, some camcorders allow deleting the last recorded clip if you use a writable disc. Otherwise, the disc needs to be reformatted to be reused. Dash R and Plus R discs cannot be reused. All disc types except for RAM need to be finalized for playing them back in a standard DVD player or to read them in a computer DVD drive. Plus RW does not need finalization if DVD menu is not created, but using it in unfinalized state in a computer DVD drive is not recommended. Also, finalization is still needed if the disc has too much free space on it. High-definition camcorders do away with the two different recording modes, VR and video, but still require discs to be finalized to play them in a Blu-ray disc player or in a computer Blu-ray disc drive. Some AVCG camcorders allow for deleting clips from -RW and +RW discs arbitrarily, but the size of the recovered space may be less than that of the original file. In other words, deleting clips to free up space is not efficient. The best option to reuse rewritable discs is to reformat them. There are several methods to transfer movie clips from a DVD disc to a computer, but first, make sure the disc is finalized. You need to do it in the camcorder, and you will likely need to power the camcorder from an AC adapter, because finalization can take up to 20 minutes. Next, if your camcorder has a USB port, connect the camcorder to a computer via USB. The camcorder should appear as an external optical drive. If the camcorder does not have a USB port, then you can use your computer DVD drive. You can buy an external one for as low as $20. Ideally, you should not be dealing with the files on the disk directly. Instead, you should use software that can import individual clips from the disk and save them into separate files. The best option is to use bundled software, but this is not always possible. If you buy a used camcorder, the software CDs are long gone. Even if they're included, your laptop likely doesn't have an optical disk drive. If you manage to find needed software, it may require an older version of operating system or a version in a different language. So let's move to the second best option, which is the import module in your video editor. For example, in Corel Video Studio, you would navigate to Capture tab, select the Import from Digital Media option, then select the DVD drive with the disc on it and click OK button. In the Import from Digital Media window, you will see all video clips available for import, where you can preview them. Select the clips you want to import, or select all of them, then click the Start Import button. When the importing finishes, you can add the imported clips to your library, or insert them directly to the timeline. Vegas Pro also can import videos from a DVD. The user interface is less sophisticated, there is no preview and no clip selection, it just imports everything. On the positive side, it does it very quickly. If your video editor cannot import videos from a DVD disc, you can use a free utility called DVD VOB to MPG to import the videos as one or several large files. The VOB files contain actual videos and can be no larger than 1 GB, so there may be more than one VOB file in a title set, and these are numbered sequentially. Start up the DVD VOB to MPG, select VOB files from the same title set you want to import, and check the Convert Input Files and Add Them to One Single File checkbox. If your DVD disc happens to contain several title sets, you'll have to import each title set separately. The resulting MPG file will contain all clips in the same order they have been recorded. Importing from a disc recorded in VR mode, which would be a RAM or -RW VR, is even easier, as it contains just a single VRO file. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment. Goodbye.